Neutral side action, and we're just about set to kick off. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Purdue will be kicking off, and you can just feel the energy in the air for this opening kickoff. Hicks from the four gets to about the 24-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. They give to the tailback. He's tackled at about the 27-yard line. Second down and 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 27. Looks for his tight end over the middle. They'll bring him down at the 35. Good pitch and catch there on second down.
Yep, it was good enough to get him the first down. That's just a nice play.
They go with a toss. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Nice play, baby. Nice play.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
The thing I love about this guy is he can throw the ball, he can run it. Man, that's hard to stop.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 41. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Corners are showing that they're not afraid to come up and make a hit. Even if they aren't playing pass, they know how to disrupt the play.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. They go to the ground, and he stops short. Right now, he wants to get this kick away and change field position. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Purdue's coaches admitted to us that they game plan around this guy. It's kind of different for a wide receiver. It's usually a running back or a quarterback, but he's paid off for him so far.
He really has, and I found it very refreshing as we travel around the country and visit with so many of these players to find a high-profile wide receiver who's a selfless guy. He's a great leader from everything that they've told us. He's a guy that wants to go out there and make sure that the team gets the win first before he gets his catches. Kind of a rare breed in today's game of college football, but he's an exceptional player.
First guy on the field and the last guy off of practice. He heaves it deep. Intercepted.
That could have been a huge shift in momentum if they were able to hold on to that one. Wow, that was close.
From their own 35-yard line. Second down. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's knocked out of bounds. Right around the 50. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
Let's go, D.
to the 41. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
So it's first down and an eternity. And they get nice yardage on that run. Straight run here, and he's got nowhere to go. Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. Under pressure. Tackle made right around the 42-yard line.
That was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
They tried to get a head start there.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
Done. Awaiting the return. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing. Fires it out. Brought down at the 24-yard line. Second down and 6. Ball on the 24-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. That's a great tackle at the 32. They go to the left for a nice game. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out. So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here. So first down once again, but a long ways to go after that penalty.
Watch 36. 36 to Mike.
He's out to the 30. Very good tackle in space. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Fires quickly, and he's got his man, and he's tackled at the 50. It out to maybe the 49-yard line. Second and 8. Ball on the 49-yard line. Good outside run there. Quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Quick strike, and he drops it. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Time about the emotions of college football. This play was definitely an emotionally charged play. What a way for the wideout to make a statement in this game.
Just throws this one away. From the 30-yard line, second down. Makes the catch, and look out. And down he goes at about the 19-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. It's second and 12. Ball on the 21. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. He's going to try and scramble. Here's an opening. Tackle around the 7-yard line. So at the end of one, no score here. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number two. And he's taken down at the 7. Defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
This should be an easy field goal. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
Purdue is looking to go up by 3. Kicks up, and it splits the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
They line up to kick this one away. He'll take it from the 2. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Now his man can't tack on any yardage. A gain of 6.
It's a decent pickup that time on a well-designed play.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Quick out to his receiver. Pryor picks him up about 3 yards with the catch.
Let's go. Two times. Two down.
And they make the stop at about the 47-yard line. From the 47-yard line. First down. He's hit and taken down. Slings it. Gets to about the 34-yard line. The running back gets 2 on the carry. From the 34-yard line, it's second down. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. It out to about the 27-yard line. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. He makes it to the 25-yard line. It's the 9th play of the drive. Makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, it's second down. Now he tries to buy some time. He's tackled at the 13-yard line. And this is the 11th play of the current drive. Nice run up the middle. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. One play and he'll lose yards.
That's what I'm talking about, baby.
13th play of the drive coming up. And he's hit immediately. First down. They've got 4 cracks at it inside the 5. It's first and goal. They'll bring him down at the 1. This is play number 15 of a very impressive drive. Taken down just outside the goal line. Big 3rd and goal. Can the defense stop him?
You get this, boy.
Fires quickly to the tight end. Touchdown! So he was able to connect with a tight end for the score.
Yeah, they did a nice job inside the red zone of mixing up the play calling. That touchdown obviously fooled the defense.
And he adds the extra point. A long 16-play, 59-yard drive. And that's good for a touchdown.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
The score now, 7-3. Taken at the 5. And down he goes at the 29. Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Nearly picked off, but he couldn't hold it.
As a defender, you want to keep your hands up. Maybe you can come away with the pick or at least deflect the ball.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 29. He's wrapped up for the sack. They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
Quickly to the tight end, incomplete.
Accuracy is such a vital part of being a quarterback. You've got to have an ability to lay the ball right into your guy's hands.
Dunn is back deep to return. He gets out to about the 48-yard line. They moved the ball very effectively on their last drive, which ended with a touchdown. The defense has been talking it over on the sideline, trying to make some corrections. Let's see if they can stop them this time.
This quarterback right now is in a rhythm, and a lot of that has to do with his preparation. You can see right now with the reads that he's being able to make, getting the football out of his hands, that he's feeling very, very confident in his ability to throw the football against this defense.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Wisconsin is up 4. Tackle made at the 29-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Now this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Quick throw, picked off.
I really like this corner's ability to read the play. He shows very good football smarts and pretty good hands, too.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. Throws this one out to the right. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. He's on the run. They'll make the sack.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
It's now third down and long. 13 yards to go for the first down after the sack. Wants to go long and does. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. Dunn is the deep man awaiting the return. Dunn fields at the 31, brought down at the 36-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Wisconsin is up by four. There's a strike complete, and he's down. Scrambling around. They bring him down. We've still got a half of football remaining. So the Badgers lead it by four.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half.
Let's not get too carried away by the numbers, but both of these teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass. It's an indication, it seems, that maybe there's not the personnel out there that really scares this defense, that can really stretch the defense.
Yeah, we talk about it all the time, having those big-time speed guys and those playmakers on the outsides that really make the cornerbacks bail and take away the deep ball. And they're not scared right now. They're just squatting on the outside and saying, you're not going to run by me, you're not going to throw it deep, and all I'm going to do is try to make sure that you catch the underneath stuff and wrap you up and tackle you. So somebody has to emerge as a playmaker, and you have to find the playmakers down the field to make some big home run plays.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Wisconsin's coaching staff will go out tonight. I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
Tackled after a decent pickup. Taken down to the backfield. It's third down and 10. Ball on the 23-yard line. Catches it, and that's all. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
Dunn, the return man. Dunn fields it at the 30, and he's tackled at the 40-yard line. It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? Wisconsin holds a 4-point lead. Gets the ball here and brought down to the backfield. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
That's a nice play there by the sophomore out of the corner. He read the run and stepped up and made a nice tackle.
It's second and 11. Ball on the 40-yard line. And he is drilled at the 34. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 34-yard line.
Two down.
Mark 55, mark 10.
Brought down around the 11-yard line.
first and 10. Ball on the 11-yard line. Fakes it, and the quarterback scrambles. And he's tackled right around the 4-yard line. Defense stacked in tight here. And down he goes, right around the 2-yard line. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Wisconsin is up 4. Quick strike, and it's caught for the touchdown.
These guys don't get tense down by the end zone. Sometimes a young quarterback will make a silly mistake or a receiver will come down with a case of stone hands, but not with this group.
And he hits the PAT. A 6-play, 59-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
From the 5-yard line. And he's hammered down. They were forced to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They'll be looking for a little more out of their offense on this possession.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
Sends it out quick. Intercepted. To the 20. And he's taken down at about the 11.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw. And that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
First and 10. Ball on the 11. Tackle right around the 12-yard line. They get a 1-yard loss on that one.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
Throws complete. He's hammered. He ran a good-looking route and picked up positive yardage.
That he did, and he made a good catch. That short passing game is where you see all those hours in the summer that you put in pay off.
It's third down and 5 to go. 6 yards to the end zone. He gets rid of this one. Somebody jumped early down there.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
They'll line up for the field goal, and this is nothing more than a chip shot. The kick is up, and they tack on 3 points. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Moore from the 6, and he makes it out to about the 27-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Level at the 22. Second and long. Ball on their own 22. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And they make the stop at the 30-yard line.
Easy, easy, easy.
Check, 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 check
gets rid of it quickly. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. And they pick up the first down with a pass to the tight end.
It's easy to forget about the tight end sometimes coming off the line, but you always have to watch this guy because he's certainly capable of making big plays.
And he's tackled right away. The quarterback down. They find themselves in a hole here after that sack. It's second and long. He's tackled around the 49-yard line. Certainly, they don't have the return on here. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Wisconsin's built on their halftime lead here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, I think they've done a really good job of finding some matchups to their advantage, and they've just gone after this defense, and it's allowed them to put up some points on the board.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Nice run, and he's brought down. It's second and five here. Ball on the 25.
If this defense keeps taking chances with these blitzes, sure, they may get to the quarterback once in a while, but they also are giving up some big plays like that one right there.
From their own 46-yard line, first down. They'll work the left side. He makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
Let's go.
Mike 36.
Tries to thread the needle, and it's not going to work. He's taken down at the 49-yard line. That INT puts him in a position to make this a game.
Yeah, they really needed that. That's a huge boost to morale.
From their own 49-yard line, it's first down. Run to the left there. He makes his way to about the 38. Set up a screen for the wide receiver. They'll bring him down at the 30. There he goes. Knocked out of bounds at the 26. decent run here, right side. So with one quarter remaining, Wisconsin leads 17-3. All right, we're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks. The 14-yard line. They go back to him on a quick throw. Brought down around the 8-yard line. Some early movement up front.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 13-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. And he's tackled around the 9-yard line. 3, maybe 4 yards on the scramble. Going to try and scramble. He gets sacked on the play. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown. And he converts the extra point. It was an 11-play, 57-yard drive, and the result, 7 points.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Hicks from the one. Tackle made at the 28. A score here might effectively end this one. Wisconsin up 7 points. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. From their own 30-yard line, it's second down. Zips it to the tight end, and he tackles him hard at the 36-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. He hits him hard at the 39-yard line.
Good call to go with the option here on third down. It confused the defense just enough to allow him to pick up the first.
That's a great tackle at the 33-yard line. So the sack makes this a second and long.
Okay, try left, try left. Down, down. Check on the
he's hit and taken down. Fires quickly to the tight end. Ferguson picks up 6 yards with that grab. Wisconsin is up 7. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. Moore, back to return it. He's to the 40. Gets to about the 44-yard line. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Hands it to the back. They'll get him for a loss. Immediately tackled. And he just gets rid of it. From the 44-yard line, it's second down. Is in and it's picked off by the safety. He's at the 30, for the 20, the 10. Touchdown! Big play.
How about the play by the defender? That was a great interception and an even better effort to bring the ball back for a touchdown.
And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 31. I have a feeling we haven't seen the end of the fireworks today.
Brad, you look up at the scoreboard, and it's clearly crunch time for this offense. They've got to be able to sustain a drive, maybe look for a big play, but they have to have points on the board right here.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Slings it, and he is drilled at the 39. And they've got the dime package in there to try and deal with this five receiver look. Quick pass. And down he goes at about the 45. Over 2 minutes in the game. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. Slides down to the ground. About 9 yards there for the quarterback. Tight end.
Go into the end zone.
Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal. First and goal from the one, looking to punch this one in. Everybody bunched up tight defensively. Touchdown, Boilermakers! Tacks on the extra point.
Oh, what a hit.
What a great effort here. Not just by the return team to cover the onside kick, but also by the kicking team to get themselves in that position in the first place.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. The tailback picks up six there on the misdirection. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Just under two to go in the game. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
The defense can't be surprised that they're running the football, but for whatever reason, they're not stepping up when they need to be able to come up with a stop.
Run, right side. Tackle at the 28-yard line. Counter play is good for about a yard. The Boilermakers using their third and last timeout. Good outside run there. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Was almost picked, and that one probably should have been picked off.
Yeah, are you kidding me? There's a blanket around that receiver. Somebody else had to be open.
Fourth down. They're going to try a long field goal here. The kick is up, and he splits the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. From the 8-yard line. He's out to the 30, and he's taken down at the 36. Time's running short here, so let's see what plays out.
Well, now you've got to be thinking end zone on every play. You just don't have the time to do anything else.
I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. Gets rid of it quickly, and he's taken down right around the 36-yard line. Stop the clock. From the 36-yard line, second down. And they make the stop right around the 20.
Good job here by the receiver. Look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Stops the clock with a spike.
It's going to be a long day. It's going to be a long day.
He's tackled at the 8. Caught, and that's a first down. It's second and goal. Ball on the 8.
Hold down.
throws it in a hurry. He's taken down at the three. So that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, 27-17, Badgers. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.